गुड आफ्टरनून डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द डेमॉन्स्ट्रेशन ऑफ एंजाइम अमाइलेज। ऑल ऑफ यू नो वॉट एंजाइम्स आर। एंजाइम्स लाइक यू हैव हर्ड अबाउट केमिकल कैटलिस्ट, एंजाइम्स आर बायो कैटलिस्ट दैट स्पीड अप द रेट ऑफ अ बायोकेमिकल रिएक्शन। ओके, एंजाइम्स आर दोज कैटलिस्ट विच कैटलाइज रिएक्शंस दैट टेक प्लेस इन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स, लिविंग सेल्स, without itself being altered in the process. Okay, so like any other chemical catalyst, enzymes are biocatalyst which speed up the rate of a biochemical reaction without actually being altered in the process. Okay, and how do enzymes speed up the rate of reaction? They speed up the rate of reaction by lowering the activation energy, by lowering the activation energy of a reaction process. Okay, they react with the substrate and form an intermediate complex which is called as enzyme substrate complex. Okay, so enzyme reacts with substrate, forms an intermediate complex called as enzyme substrate complex, and that is a transition state that requires less energy for reaction to proceed. Right, now the unstable intermediate compound formed quickly breaks down and forms the reaction product and enzyme is released free. Okay, so E plus S, that means enzyme plus substrate, form ES complex, enzyme substrate complex. This complex is unstable and rapidly breaks down into product P plus enzyme E is regained back. This enzyme can again react with other substrate molecules. Okay, now let us discuss and one more thing. Every enzyme is very specific for its substrate. It acts on one particular substrate or that particular substrate for which it is specific. Why? Because there is a certain region of the enzyme which is called as active site that binds to the substrate. The active site is like a pocket or a groove or a cavity. The active site is a cavity or a groove or a pocket which is formed by folding of the protein chains. Okay, this three-dimensional structure together with the chemical and electrical properties of the amino acids and cofactor within the active site permit only a particular substrate to bind to it. Okay, thus it determines the enzyme specificity. In simple terms, every enzyme is protein in nature and it is made up of amino acids. The amino acid chains are called as polypeptide chains. They fold in a particular configuration when primary, secondary and tertiary or quaternary structures stabilize the structure of a protein. Okay, and in every enzyme there is a pocket or a groove which we call as active site, which is formed due to the folding of the protein chains, and into this active site only one particular substrate can fit or a particular substrate can fit, and hence we say that every enzyme is specific for its substrate. Now today we are going to talk about enzyme amylase. Amylase is an extracellular enzyme secreted by microorganisms like bacteria and fungi. Okay, amylase, what we are going to study today is about bacterial amylase. Actually, amylase enzyme is produced in living organisms like human beings also, in our saliva. Okay, but today we are going to study about bacterial amylase. So what is an amylase enzyme? It is an important metabolic enzyme. The function of amylase enzyme is to catalyze the breakdown or hydrolysis of starch into smaller molecules. Okay, so amylase enzyme is produced by many bacteria as well as by fungi, and it is an extracellular enzyme. That means organisms secrete the enzyme and it is released outside the cell, so we call it extracellular enzyme. What is the function of the enzyme? To break down starch, to hydrolyze starch into small molecules like dextrin, maltose and finally glucose. Why? Because starch is made up of glucose. Now let us talk about starch. Starch is a homopolysaccharide. Actually, it is made up of alpha D-glucose units. Starch is composed of two polymers. What are those? Amylose, which is a straight chain or linear polymer, and amylopectin. Okay, so starch is made up of amylose, which is a straight chain
polymer or a linear polymer, and another is amylopectin. Amylopectin is a branched polymer. Okay, so starch is made up of amylose and amylopectin. Both amylose and amylopectin are made up of alpha D glucose units. But what is the difference? Amylose is a linear polymer, amylopectin is a branched polymer. Okay, now in case of amylose, the alpha amylose LOSE, okay, in amylose, alpha D glucose units are joined to each other by alpha 1,4 glycosidic bond. Okay, in amylopectin, there are two types of linkages, alpha 1,4 by which one glucose molecule is joined to another, and there is also alpha 1,6 glycosidic bond. Alpha 1,6 glycosidic bond is present at the branching point, wherever there is a branching. So amylose, linear polymer made up of alpha D glucose unit joined by alpha 1,4 glycosidic bond. Amylopectin, branched polymer made up of alpha D glucose units joined by alpha 1,4, and at the branching point there is alpha 1,6 glycosidic linkage. Okay, the degree of branching in amylopectin is approximately around 1 per 25 to 30 glucose units. Okay, now so that is about starch. So what is the action of enzyme starch, enzyme amylase? It acts upon starch, breaks it down first into larger molecules like dextrin, and further when the enzyme is allowed to act further, it further breaks down starch into maltose, which is a disaccharide, and finally into glucose. Okay, now starch is very large molecule to pass through the bacterial membrane. Okay, therefore to be of metabolic value to the bacteria, it must be first broken down into individual glucose molecules. Now those organisms which can secrete the extracellular enzyme, that is alpha amylase and one more enzyme, oligo 1,6 glucosidase, they are able to completely hydrolyze starch. Okay, action of alpha amylase is hydrolysis of starch, but for complete hydrolysis, oligo 1,6 glucosidase enzyme is also required. These two enzymes together break it down into maltose, a disaccharide, then into a monosaccharide, that is glucose, and these mono and disaccharides, that is glucose or maltose, can now be taken up by the cell. Okay, now amylase production takes place in bacteria as well as in fungi. What is the basic principle behind this test? The ability of the enzyme to degrade starch is used as a criteria for determination of amylase production by a microorganism. Okay, if you want to study whether the given organism produces enzyme amylase or not, how you are going to check? By its ability to degrade starch. Okay, so what do we do in the laboratory? We perform starch hydrolysis by the test organism. Okay, if the organism, test organism, is able to hydrolyze starch, the organism produces enzyme amylase. If the test organism is not able to hydrolyze or degrade starch, the organism does not produce amylase enzyme. Okay, so whether the organism is amylase producing, that is amylase positive, or whether the organism is amylase non-producing, amylase negative, can be checked by simple starch hydrolysis test. Okay, and in this test we use iodine as indicator. Okay, now what happens if you prepare starch agar? What you have to do is, for preparing starch agar, you have to prepare nutrient agar and add 1% starch powder into it. That means 1 gram starch in 100 ml of nutrient agar. Okay, and you pour it into the plate. Now this is called as a starch agar plate. Starch reacts with iodine to give a dark blue black color, a dark blue black, or you can say dark violet color. So if you have a starch agar plate and if you pour iodine into that plate, the whole plate will turn dark blue or dark blue black, because iodine reacts with starch and gives a blue color. Okay, but the breakdown products of starch, that is dextrin or maltose or glucose, do not react with iodine and do not give any color. Okay, so now if you have inoculated the organism on plate and the organism produces enzyme amylase, that enzyme will be released in the surrounding of the bacterial colony, and in that area starch will be hydrolyzed. So if and then after inoculation and incubation, when you pour iodine into the plate, and if you see a clear zone, colorless clear zone surrounding the colony, it is called as clear zone of starch hydrolysis. Then you conclude that organism is amylase positive or amylase producing. If there is no clear zone surrounding the colony and the whole plate turns blue, then organism is amylase negative. Okay. The size of the clear zone of hydrolysis is directly proportional to the amount of amylase produced and starch hydrolyzing activity of the organism, right? So, the clear zone indicates hydrolysis of starch into monosaccharides which cannot bind the iodine molecule. Right. Starch in the presence of iodine produces dark blue color. The medium, as iodine is trapped in the helical structure of starch. A yellow or a clear zone around a colony in a blue medium indicates the amylolytic activity, that means amylase producing activity of an organism. The clear zone indicates hydrolysis of starch into monosaccharide which cannot bind to iodine molecule, and hence there is a clear zone surrounding the colony. Okay, so what do you need for the experiment? Starch agar plate, iodine inoculating loop and test organism, that is Bacillus subtilis and E. coli. What you have to do is, as I told you have to prepare starch agar. Okay, and the starch agar is poured inside the plate. Starch agar means nutrient agar containing 1% starch. So you pour the, sterilize the plate, sterilize the medium, pour the medium into the petri dish. Okay, now, so this is a starch agar plate. You take the test organism Bacillus subtilis in one plate and E. coli in another plate, or you can inoculate both the organism into the plate. So you either spot inoculate with the test organism in the center of the plate, or you can do it in a line, zigzag manner, like a streak line we call it. Okay, and then most of the time what we do is we spot inoculate the organism. Okay, so we spot inoculate. After spot inoculation, what you do? Incubate. Okay, incubate the plate at 37 degrees Celsius for 24 hours. After 24 hours, what you have to add into the plate? Iodine. Okay, we have to pour iodine. If the organism produces enzyme amylase, what will happen? Okay, if I am talking about, if the organism, this is the inoculation point of the organism. If the organism produces enzyme amylase, then enzyme will be released in the surrounding of the organism, that is colony, and starch will be hydrolyzed in that area. Okay, starch hydrolysis will take place in that area. And when you pour iodine into the plate, the rest of the plate will turn violet. Here the color is red, but in our case, when we pour iodine, the point where starch is intact, the whole plate will turn dark blue or violet. But there only there will be a clear zone of starch hydrolysis surrounding the colony. This clear zone is called a zone of starch hydrolysis. So after incubation, after inoculation, incubation, and after pouring iodine, if you see a clear zone of starch hydrolysis surrounding the colony, which is colorless, you say that organism is amylase producing. If the colony is not surrounded by any clear zone, then the organism is amylase negative or amylase non-producing. Okay. So, spot inoculate, incubate, after incubation, pour iodine, right? Okay, result interpretation positive, a clear zone around the line of the growth or spot inoculation. Negative test means dark blue coloration of the medium. E. coli is amylase non-producing, so negative. Bacillus subtilis gives positive reaction. You can see a clear zone surrounding the colony. So these are control plates. The first is starch agar and the second plate B, starch agar, where you have added iodine, you can see a blue color. Okay. Now this is negative test. You have inoculated the organism in plate A. We have inoculated the organism. In plate B, you have poured iodine. Can you see any clear zone surrounding the growth of the organism? No. So organism is amylase negative. So this picture is showing negative, amylase negative organism or amylase non-producing organism. Okay. Now look at this. Okay. In both the plates, here in the first plate, you can see here, there is a yellowish zone around the colony. That means organism is amylase producing, and clear zone of starch hydrolysis can be seen. This is a colony of E. coli, which is amylase negative. The first is the colony of Bacillus subtilis, amylase positive. Okay, you can see in the second plate, there is a clear zone around the colony. There is a yellow colored colony in the center, yellowish colored, and you can see a clear zone surrounding the colony. That is a clear zone of starch hydrolysis. So in both the plates, we can see positive reaction wherein the colony is surrounded by a clear zone of starch hydrolysis, indicating that organism is amylase producing. Amylase produce breaks down starch into smaller molecules which do not react with iodine, and hence no color is seen surrounding the colony. So if you see a clear zone, organism is amylase producing. If you don't see a clear zone surrounding the colony, organism is amylase negative. This is how we demonstrate the enzyme amylase production by a bacteria. That is all.